In 2009, Chang Gung University in Taoyuan established a research center dedicated to the study of viruses. This year, the Research Center for Emerging Viral Infections has found itself on the front line of the global fight against COVID-19.
Over the past few months, university researchers have worked tirelessly to provide pathogen identification and other lab support crucial to containing the virus. In collaboration with other research units, they're also developing prevention and treatment strategies that bring the pandemic to an earlier end.
就是说像现在病人身上啊，到底有没有有效的抗体？
Dr. Shih Shin-ru is here with a researcher discussing the results of a virus antibody test. Dr. Shih has worked as a virologist specializing in enterovirus and influenza for more than 20 years. When COVID-19 broke out, she didn't miss a beat, leading her graduate students on a fight against the epidemic.
在这里呢，我们可以看到比较靠近源头是我们案例比较早。
Here we can see that the ones closer to the source are cases from earlier on. There are people with a travel history to Wuhan.
The Research Center for Emerging Viral Infections conducted a comprehensive analysis of local data using an international public access COVID database. Researchers were able to track the global evolutionary trajectories of the virus. And by drilling down on domestic cases, they are finding ways to suppress the development of the virus.
我常常会跟学生聊，就是我们做这件事情最终的目的是为什么？I'll often talk about this with my students. That is, I'll say, this work we're doing, what's the ultimate goal of it all? It's to resolve the pandemic, to help patients get better. I feel that this is a better North Star to look toward, as opposed to wanting to win first place or to publish a great dissertation or perhaps even to cash in on an expensive technology transfer.
With her patient-centric approach, Dr. Shih is researching the potential of traditional Chinese herbs and medicines as a more affordable defense against viral invasion.
这一块来讲，其实所谓的救穷人的药啦，我们所谓的抗体药物或是新研发的。With
regard to that research, we're looking for a so-called medicine for the poor. What we call antibody drugs or the newly developed therapy remdesivir are extremely expensive. In Central and South America and in Africa, how can people afford such medicines? So we're resolved to pursue this path. And it's educational. That is, students are very motivated to do this. Of course, this work may not be profitable, but it doesn't matter. This is one of those very important responsibilities that come up in life, this COVID-19. We hope that the products can in fact be used on patients, and we need to work with industrial partners. Perhaps our students and faculty can start up a business to get these good products out there. So that is what we are currently doing.